What's up, fam? Brandon here. So there have been many cases in my musical journey where I've been asked to fill in for a band, and they'll call me up like 3 days before the gig and say, hey, we need you to fill in. Can you do it? And of course, I say yes. And they're like, okay, here's a set list. And there's 40 songs that I've never played before. So I found a quick, easy way to chart out the songs. That way I can have the sheets next to me on stage and I can look and I can understand it and I can play the whole song pretty much the way it's supposed to be. It saved my ass on so many gigs, I cannot even tell you. The band Liquid Blue I play with, they play like 600 songs. So I had to learn like 400 songs before doing the cruise ships as well. And so charting songs out this way has helped me immensely. You gotta do your homework. You don't wanna show up to the gig and not know what you're doing, not know the songs. You wanna be prepared. You wanna be a reliable musician. So last week I had a gig like this. An original band hit me up and they said, hey, we have a gig. Can you do it? And I said, yes. I had like a week to prepare the material, and I did it this way. I charted out the songs. Boom, right here. We played the gig and it was great. We had one rehearsal together, which was nice. Sometimes you don't even get a rehearsal. Actually, there have been so many cases where the bands that I work with, we do not rehearse. I feel like when you get to the professional level, you're expected to show up to the gig and know the material. Everyone in the band has done their own homework. And you reach a certain caliber where it's like, okay, we shouldn't have to rehearse. We shouldn't have to spend the time to rehearse. So I'm gonna pick a random song on Spotify, like top 40. And show you guys how I chart the songs out. That way you don't fuck it up on the gig. Cool? So this is kind of how I chart things out. So I make a little strip. I make my lines in the paper. And at the top, I write the main groove of the song. Sometimes there's two grooves. Like here you'll see in the verse, here's one groove. And then here's the groove for the chorus. And then down here, I write out the format of the song. So intro, verse one, chorus one, and so on. So that's kind of how I do it. So one big thing to note with this is to understand like basic song structures. I'd say 80% of songs have like a similar structure, right? The typical song structure is like intro, verse one, chorus one, verse two, chorus two, bridge or a solo, and then the final chorus, and then that's it. That's pretty much used in most music. And if you understand that structure, then it'll help you a lot when you're on stage, because you'll play 8 bars of a verse and be like, okay, I think we're going into the chorus. And 80% of the time, you go into the chorus. And then after the chorus, what happens? You go back into the verse. It gets pretty predictable after a while. But it's good to know that. All right, so I'm gonna pick a random song on Spotify, like something top 40, today's top hits. Whatever's okay. Here With Me by Marshmello. Can I tell you something? I never played this song. I've only heard it like 2 times or whatever on the radio, so we'll chart this song out. So I'm guessing it's gonna have a similar format to what we said before. I'm guessing there's gonna be an intro, a verse, a chorus, a second verse, a second chorus, a bridge. I don't remember if there's one in this song. I don't think so, actually. I think it's just 2 verses and 2 choruses, and that's it. So let's see. So first I section off the paper, that way like one song can fit within a 2-inch line, basically. So use a straight edge, since I'm freaking OCD. You gotta use Quidditch Through the Ages, you know, for all you Harry Potter fans out there. Okay, I usually make 2 lines. So the grooves go up here, and then the song format goes down here. All right, so I'm gonna listen to the song and chart it out as we go. I'm gonna listen to it twice. So the first time, I'm gonna chart out the song structure. And then the second time, I'm gonna write out the grooves. So here we go. So verse one, right out the gate. So 8 bars. Okay, drums come in the second half of the verse. So it's still verse one. Another 8 bars. It's like pre-chorus. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 2. Counting out the bars. Six. Seven. Eight. Chorus. I'm guessing it's 8 bars. Verse. I'm gonna take a guess that this verse is 8 bars as well. 7. 8. Back in the pre-chorus. Chorus. That's it. So it's all 8 bar sections. Starts with the intro, or verse 1, technically, where there's no drums, 8 bars. Drums come in for the second half of the verse, another 8 bars. Pre-chorus, 8 bars. Chorus, 8 bars. Verse 2, 8 bars. Another pre-chorus, 8 bars. And then the chorus, another 8 bars. When I write these out, right above it, I usually kind of write what the drums are doing. So let's see, in the pre-chorus, there's like a hand clap, so you're just keeping time pretty much on the 2 and the 4. So I'm going to write time above it, which basically lets me know that you're just keeping time there. Verse 1, there's no drums. I wrote drums above the second half of verse 1, so that's when I know the drums come in. From listening to it, there's two types of grooves. There's the groove during the verse, and then the groove during the chorus. So I'm going to listen to it again, and chart out the grooves. Oh, I forgot to mention, up here in the left corner, I usually write the title of the song, so you know what song you're about to play, you know? Here with me. I'm glad you guys are here with me today, learning how to chart songs and how to be a better musician. All right, let's listen to it again. I'm gonna chart out the grooves. Boom, ga, boom, ga, boom, ga, boom, ga, boom, boom, ga. Okay. So that's the first groove. I'm going to say we're doing quarter notes on the hi-hat there. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Boom. Got. Boom, got. So I write that. You can even make a little eighth note tail there if you want to be a Berkeley cat or whatever. You can even put an eighth note rest in there if you want to. I'm not a huge stickler on that. I can kind of understand what's going on there. So, and then the second half of it, it's different, slightly different. So let's see. There's one more kick at the end there. So that's pretty much it. Boom, got, boom, got, boom, got, boom, got, boom, boom. All right. So that's the first groove. Right up here, I'll just write verse. So I know, that's the groove for the verse. Let's listen to the chorus. All right, so I'm gonna try and get those ghost notes in there. I don't know if I'm gonna have space for this here. I'm gonna write it really tiny because there's not much space. So let's see. I'm gonna try and give me as much space as possible here. Yeah, and I didn't get any formal training of charting songs and stuff, so I'm sure there's some
some formal cats out there that's like gonna be like, you're charting this wrong. But you know what? The point of this is for you to understand it. So this is the way I chart things out. This is the way I understand it. So these are actually gonna be 16th notes. I don't wanna like clutter it up with 16th notes, but so I'm gonna put the backbeat in there. Because there's always a snare on the 2 and the 4. Boom, ka, boom, boom, ka, boom, ka, boom, boom, ka, boom, boom. So it's pretty similar to the verse here, but besides a couple extra kick drums, forget it. I'll write these 16ths in there. Just for the hell of it. I know what's going on. So we got our freaking 16th notes up there. It's looking pretty hectic. That's the main part of the groove. I'm gonna try and hear what ghost notes are going on so I can chart out the ghost notes too. All right, so that's the whole groove. So 16ths on the hats, two hands, with all the ghost notes in there. Boom, gap, get, boom, gap, get, boom, gap, get, boom, gap, get, boom. All right, guys, so I'm gonna try and play the song. I got my notes here. We're pretending like Marshmallow hit us up earlier today. He's like, hey, I got a gig tonight. I need you to fill in. Can you do it? We said yes. Did we have time to practice? No, but we charted it out. That's good enough. 20,000 people.
Can I tell you something just between you and me? When I hear your voice, I know I'm finally free. Every single word is perfect as it can be. And I need you here with me. When you lift me up, I know that speak to you by saying nothing at all. Every single time I find it harder to breathe, 'cause I need you here with me. Every day you're saying the words that I want you to say. There's a pain in my heart and it won't go away. Now I know I'm falling in deep, 'cause
missed a few notes, but I still count that as a pass. I think if people were at the concert, there wouldn't be someone in the crowd going, oh, the drummer missed that kick drum on the end of 3. I'm never seeing Marshmallow again. So, yeah, I mean, for me, it's been very effective. I've put like 10 songs on one page before, and it has gotten me through gigs. Tried and tested, and it works. It helped me so much. So, if you guys ever have any gigs coming up, you need to learn a bunch of songs in a short amount of time, and you don't want to chart out the whole thing. This is kind of like the Spark Notes version, you know? And make it your own. Like, write down whatever you need to understand the song, because the notes aren't for anyone else. The notes are for you. So this is how I do it. This is what helps me, and I'm sure it'll help you guys too. So I hope this was helpful. I know it's kind of a different drum lesson, not necessarily on drumming. but something useful, which is sometimes more important.
I want you guys to let me know what you want to see. So if you guys have any ideas for videos, like lessons or whatever, shoot me a comment below. Tell me what you guys want to see, because I want to know. I want to create content for you guys that you guys can enjoy. Cool. I will see you guys in the next lesson.